Like a pretty bitch that get it off the muscle. Ain't never handy nothing, all she know is hustle. Grinding from sundown till it come up. I salute the young bosses on the come up. Put the work in, remain humble, they gon' hear us. When you really bossed up, you ain't never gotta do much. He wanna chill, I'm like, nigga, take a number.
What's up, YouTube? What's poppin'? It's Kieran A, and I am finally back with another video. Although it has been a busy 2 or 3 weeks, I think it's only been 2 weeks since I made a video. I've been very busy with my business is doing great, and etc. And it's time to get back on YouTube and give y'all some tips and advice. So in this video, I will be telling you the story time of how I name my business, as well as giving you advice on how to name your business. But before we get into this, hi, my name is Kieran A. I'm 16 years old. I'm the owner of K Hustle, and I would love for you to subscribe to my channel. If you're new to my channel, what is up? What is popping? Like I said, nice Kieran A. I'm 16 years old, and please subscribe to my channel. It's a big red button. It says subscribe. I would love for you to subscribe. I do post frequently. I try to post every week about business, help, business advice, and etc. If you ever have a recommendation for a video, always DM me. My personal social media will be in the description box, as well as my business website, my business Instagram, and etc. If you're a return subscriber, what is up? What is popping? Thank you so much for coming back and supporting me. Yes, I talk really fast, by the way. I'm gonna try to slow down a little bit. So yeah, this video is about, like I said, how to name your business, how I name my business. I will be giving y'all a video today as well as Tuesday, which will basically be a Q&A from my followers on Instagram about my business. So yeah, but like I said, if you have any recommendations, you need help with anything, I'll make a video and upload it for you guys. But yeah, let's get into this video. So of course on my lips is K Hustle lip gloss, period. And the chains, you guys, look. My hair is all in the way. Butterfly chain, it's only $25. And then we got the initial chain, it's only $20. K Hustle, this, because I know somebody asked me the other day, where'd you get it from? And it's honestly, I just rocked it on my head. But I think I'm gonna add it to my website. I don't know. But yeah. So, how I named my business K Hustle. So, one day in the summertime, let me get all cozy, you know. In the summertime, I had needed to go to the post office. It was when I had my summer business. It was KRC Collection. I just sell like do-rags and headbands and bonnets, like just that stuff. And had 2 or 3 packages. And that day, we had to go to Tallahassee. We was getting ready to go to Tallahassee. So it was so hot that day. It was so hot. Mind you, the post office closes at 4:30. And the time that I needed to go, like I was needing to go out the house right away to get to the post office so I won't be late, it's 4:30. I'm at 4 o'clock. The post office closes at 4:30. So like 4 o'clock, I went to my mom and I was like, can you take me to the post office real quick? She was like, yes, I'll take you, just wait a minute. But mind you, it's already 4 o'clock, and I mean, the post office ain't nothing but a mile away from my house, so it's not that long. Like if you walk, it'll take a good 15 minutes to get there. If you drive, it'll take a good 5 minutes. But I was like, listen, I need to get there at least like no later than 4:15. It was already 4 o'clock, and I was not trying to hear that. I was like, I need to go ship these 2 or 3 packages off. I need to get them shipped out. These people need their order right away. And they weren't pre-order items, they were on hand items. So I packaged it up, I needed to get it out, and I didn't have a website back then. I was going through DM. So she was like, I'll take you, once she was done getting dressed. So I was like, okay. So I went back in my room and I got the 2 or 3 packages and I put them in a bag, and I was finna go walk to the post office, because usually I was walking anyways. Before my mama started taking me to the post office, I used to walk. Like the whole summer, I just walked straight to the post office and back. Like it'd take 20-25 minutes to walk there and back. Like together it took 25 minutes. But I mean, that's the hustle, you mean? Like if you have a business, you need to go to the post office. You gonna do what you need to do by any means. Even if it's 1 package, 2 package, 3 package, treat that package like it's a million packages. Don't treat 1 package like it's just 1 package. Treat that like it's a million. Show your customers that you care about fast shipping. Like that's your business. Hustle is hustle. But yeah, go back to what I said. I went back in my room, I grabbed the packages, grabbed the bag, put it in there, and then I started feeling dizzy in my room, and I was just like, let me sit down. So I sat down And once I sat down for like 2, 3, 4, 5 minutes. Once I sat down, I got back up. I was like, okay, I'm fine. And then I started walking to the bathroom and I couldn't breathe. Like, my breath was shortening. Like, it was like that. It was like that. So I had went into the bathroom and like I was dizzy. Now I couldn't breathe. And I don't have asthma, y'all. I don't have asthma at all. Like, sometimes I'll have like panic attack, like where I can't breathe like that. But it wasn't a panic attack. Like, I just couldn't breathe. And then so I turned the shower on and I sat in the shower. Like, I just sit my whole body in the shower. Like, I put my legs in the shower and I sat there and did like heavy breaths. I was like, so I sat there for about 5 minutes. So now, y'all, I asked her at 4 o'clock, could she take me? I wasn't being patient at all. And so now it's like 4:10, 4:15. So I don't walk up there. I decide not to walk up there. I get out the shower. I go get the bike. So we got bikes for Christmas. My mama got us the bikes. So we had 3 or 4 bikes in the yard. So I get the bike and I drive. Not I drive, but I ride the bike. I think I rode the bike the back way from my house. I rode the bike the back way. So what the back way basically was, it was like a straight road to the post office. Like, you go down that road and the post office right there. It's the longest straight road ever, but it's not like curves in the road. Like, the front way is a lot of curves. Like, you gotta go straight, curve again, curve one time, and you're there. But the back way is just straight road. So I take the straight road there and I park the bicycle at where my mama's property was, by the post office, because like the post office is uptown. So she had like a building up there uptown, like my family's building. Like, y'all know what I'm trying to say, their building that they bought, like their land was up there. Like, it's right in front of the post office. So I parked the bike up there and I'm okay. Like, I'm doing fine. Like, I'm not feeling dizzy, I'm not feeling faint, I'm not like breathing heavy. So I'm walking, I parked the bike and I'm walking across the street. I was like, I feel good, I finally made it here. I mean, it's only like 4:20. I'm good, I made it here on time. Gonna get these packages off, I'm good. So I go into the post office, and then, you know, you go into the post office and it's just like mailboxes, like the post mailboxes. Then you got to go into another door and like that's where you can ship off the packages in, and it's like a customer service in there. So I go in there, and this is a time where I used to cut out shipping labels or like write it, all the packages. Now I just like do it through Shopify, where it automatically does the names on there. I can show y'all what I'm talking about. Actually, if you watch the video where I showed the office tours, then you know what I'm talking about. Like, I used to handwrite the shipping address, but that's the time I was doing it. I wasn't just printing off labels where I could just drop it off and come out. I had to pay there. So I'm in there, and all of them knew me because I'd be up there every week faithfully, Friday, Saturday, every week faithfully. So I went up there, and I remember I had two or three black mailers, and he was like, how are you doing? I was like, I'm doing great. So I told him, he said, would you like to ship these? I said, yes, sir, I would. And then he sat right there. He did the weight. Y'all know, if you ever mail something off, they weigh the weight of the package. And then he was telling me my total. I don't really remember much after this. Like, this is as much as I remember. I just remember handing him the money, like me leaning over and like blanking like this, like blanking, like long blanks, and me handing him the money. And he was like, Miss Cameron, are you okay? And I was just like, I just remember nodding my head. And then I had blacked out for a couple of minutes. I don't know how long it was. And then when I had opened my eyes again, I was sitting in a chair, and like post lady was handing me a cup of water, and they had my phone. They was like, oh my goodness, call your mother. Cause you know, mama, she told me to wait. I should have waited. But still, so like, I was on the phone with my cousin when I was riding my bike, just to make sure if something did happen to me, like, she would get off the phone and like call somebody to let them know. So yeah, I was on the phone with her, and I guess they had hung the phone up on her, or maybe she had hung up the phone, because when I was sitting in the chair and they gave me the water and they was like, what's your mom's number? They were trying to find my phone. I was like, it's this one. But my mom didn't answer, so they had to call my brother and this and that and this and that. So we're sitting there just waiting. They called my mom and she was like, she's coming. So we're sitting there waiting. We waited about probably good 4 or 5 minutes. That's how long it take to get to the post office. And while we were waiting, it was three post office workers. It was one man and two ladies, and then it was two customers. It was one customer, he asked me, did you want a Gatorade? And like, y'all, I still am like this, but I don't want to waste anybody's money. Like, please don't buy me anything. I'll buy it for myself. I don't want to spend nobody's money. Like, I'm like that. Like, and I was like, no sir, I'm fine. He was like, you sure? I said, yes sir, it's okay, I'm fine. And then they got me another cup of water. And when my mama came in, she was like, oh my goodness, what happened? And it was like, she passed out. It was like, her color was all pale and stuff like that. And then the post office worker was like, yeah, if he would have never walked in and caught her, she would have fell on the floor. I was just thinking, wow, I'm really over here hustling this hard. And then the man that had caught me, apparently, he was like, yeah, I wasn't going to leave until you came up here. And then, so I had got up and I had said, thank you guys. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Then I had picked up my package. I had a package up there. I had ordered a shirt, a Rich Royce shirt. So y'all picked up my package and we walk in. I'm sorry, y'all. I really wanted my notifications. We walk into the car, right? And she's like, Kamara told you to wait. And I was like, I know. I had to get out the packages, though. And I was thinking in my head, I am hustling this hard. Like, this is what you call pure hustle. Can nobody say that I'm not hustling for real? And I was just like, my next business, like, my sincere business is going to be K-Hustle. K-Hustle. That's what it's going to be. K-Hustle. So, yeah. So, now my business name is K-Hustle LLC. A lot of people refer it to Shop K Hustle just because on Instagram I couldn't get it to just like BK Hustle. So it's Shop K Hustle on Instagram. K Hustle LLC is the legal business name. So yeah. And y'all, mind y'all, I had on like a tank top. Oops. Had on a tank top and wavy pants. And it was hot outside. Like, I didn't have long sleeves or nothing. Like, I had on appropriate clothes. And I still started that. I don't know what was wrong with me. But yeah, that's how K Hustle name came to be. I know it's like a weird story, but every single time I tell somebody the story, they were like, "Oh wow, that's cool." Like they're like, I was speaking to one of my friends. They was like, "I've never had a story behind my name like that." I was just like, "Yeah." I'm over here trying to figure out why this phone ain't charging off so I can do my Q&A in my next video. But, so let me give y'all some tips on how you can name your business. I don't know if I did a video like this before, though, on how to name your business. I think I did one, I just didn't post it. But, I'm gonna give y'all five tips, maybe five things that could help y'all. One, of course, a life event. Two, a family member. Three, a favorite color, of course. Four, something that goes along with what you're selling. So if you're selling like scissors, because I see scissors right here, paper cut. I know that's a weird name. Paper cut, something like that. Or you name it after your favorite movie, inspirational movie or something like that. Honestly, I'm not really good at names. Like, I'm not really creative about names. I think a lot of my creative ideas come from me staying up at night and thinking. But that idea right there came from a life event. So yeah, I hope you guys like this story time, and hopefully something in this video y'all could be like, oh well, maybe I need to think about a life event, or oh, maybe I need to think about this and that, and your business name will come up. Think of a name that's different. Like, I see so many names that be the same. Like, they always have boutique at the end or collection at the end, which is nothing wrong with that. Just like, maybe Spaz and Daz Boutique, Spaz and Jazz Boutique, Pink Clash, Plink Clean, wait, Double Cup Pink Collection. I don't know, random name. In My Bag Collection, like something like that. They say really different. So yeah, I hope you guys like this video. Don't forget to comment, subscribe, like, and this is uncut, raw. I ain't gotta make know it is. But yeah, I'll see you guys next time with a straight Q&A. And thank you guys so much.